Hello, my name is Xander and welcome back to another Django tutorial. In this tutorial, we learn how to create a custom model field validator using RegexValidator. Django comes with a number of pre-built validators for use with model and form fields. In this simple example, we have a model called products. Now, a product requires a product website ID. And hypothetically, I want to create four sets of numbers here, which represents a website ID. And these numbers may represent different things to me or my business. Although we could just type this in every time we add a product, I want to make sure there's a certain level of consistency when staff enter numbers into the product website ID. So therefore, I want to create some sort of validator so that when users type in a number into the web product website ID, it therefore checks to make sure that the numbers are correctly formatted based upon the expectations of that field. So here the field is expecting there to be three numbers, two numbers, two numbers, and then three numbers. So I want to create this setup. So what I'm going to do now is utilize RegexValidator to create this type of functionality. Now I could go ahead and create my own custom model field. And this was just really an example of how potentially you might utilize, in a simplistic case, the RegexValidator. I've gone ahead and mocked up this simple application. We have a core and an inventory app. Inside of our inventory app, we have a model here, or the models file. Inside of here, we have just one table, products. And you can see that I've got the web ID. So let's go ahead and apply RegexValidator to the web ID field. So first of all, we're going to need to bring in from the core Django core validators, the RegexValidator. Of course, if you head over to the Django documentation, you're going to find the validators. And you can see here that I'm utilizing or showing an example here of the RegexValidator. And you can see there are plenty of others to have a read through. So now let's go ahead and configure our validator. So in the web ID field, I'm going to go ahead and add my validator, and that's going to be RegexValidator. And that takes us into the world of regular expression operations. And this is definitely something you want to have a read through if you get a little bit of time, because if you are working in web, no doubt you'll come across this quite often, particularly potentially if you're utilizing or working on Django projects. So just pointing to where or what we need to know at this point, the R. So everything string literal prefixed with the R. So we're going to start off with the R. And then if we look at the syntax, we need to know what it is we need to create. So you can see here slash, this is going to either escape special characters, or it's going to allow us to create some sort of pattern or express some sort of pattern. So we've got the backslash there. So in addition to that, we're going to be auto utilizing D. So if we move down, apologies, it's never easy to kind of follow this. But here we're using D, so for Unicode string patterns. So what we're going to try and do here is we're going to try and create a pattern using backslash D, so this special character, and that's going to define the pattern of which we want to create. So going back here, for example, you can see this is the pattern we want XXX-XX-XX-XXX. So for each X, we're going to need to create a D, for example, in this pattern that we want to build. Okay, so I'm oversimplifying it there potentially, but hopefully you kind of get what's going on here if you're not familiar with the regular expression. So here we start with the R, and we're going to say any DDDD. So remember, D is going to refer to a character that we're going to need to enter. And then we have the dash. So notice that the dash isn't escaped first using the backslash. So that's going to be kind of expected, the dash. And then we have the DD again to indicate a character of some sort, a number or a string. And then we have the dash again. And then we have two more Ds representing two characters, and then DDD. So you can see by looking at these Ds here in the dash, that's the pattern that we're forming. And that's the pattern that we're trying to validate against. I just remembered I have actually built another tutorial. So if you go over to the homepage of the Very Academy YouTube channel and just go to search and type in regular, that should bring up a few different tutorials. One here is an introduction to the regular expressions, and that should give you a basic overview of some of these different principles that we're introducing in this tutorial. So now we can also go ahead and define the max length, because we know that all these characters here, they all add up to 13. So that's also going to provide some sort of validation, if you like, in that there has to be a maximum length of 13. So in addition, you can also see that we have the help text, and I've also then described the format, and that's what's going to be shown in the admin panel. So once you've gone ahead and made migrations and migrated, and then gone ahead and created some sort of admin area for products, you can now then go ahead and test. So let's, for example, type in something irrelevant, and let's go ahead and press save. And you can see here that we're getting an error. If you go back to the Django documentation, you can see here some of the other parameters that we can pass in. And one of them is message, for example. So we can set up our own message. So for example, back in the models here, let's just say message equals wrong format entered. There we go. Okay, so we've added a new message. Let's just wrap that so you can see. It looks like we put that in the wrong place. So let's just make sure this is correct. It needs to be after. There we go. Okay, so let's take a look at this. So if I go ahead again and just save that again, you can now see we have our custom message. So let's go ahead and just add the correct numbers. Just check to make this sure this is working. Okay, so you can see that we can't add more than 13 characters. If I try to add in more, it won't let me. And let's press save, and everything is okay. So there we have a very simple custom model field validator using Regex Validator. Of course, there's much more to this, and I wanted to introduce, or at least just point you towards, some interesting reading material in this tutorial. One of them being, if you haven't already started reading regular expression operators, and then secondly, having a look at some of the built-in Django validators for models and forms. So as per normal, thank you very much for listening, and I do hope to see you in the next tutorial.